The U.S. Commerce Secretary Gina Raimondo meets with members of the Philippine business sector. Jackie Pascual is on the line to give us a wrap of the visiting U.S. delegation's trade mission in the Philippines. Hi, Jackie. What happened so far?
Hi, good afternoon, Stanley. U.S. Commerce Secretary Gina Raimondo continued with her meetings for the final day of the U.S. Presidential Trade and Investment Mission in the Philippines. She met with various business groups, including the Makati Business Club, Management Association of the Philippines, the American Chamber of Commerce of the Philippines, and the U.S. ASEAN Business Council. She said the U.S. is choosing to prioritize the Philippines as the country is now more welcoming to foreign businesses, especially American companies. Let's listen to a part of Secretary Raimondo's message.
President Marcos, it seems to me, is doing all the right things to make your country more business friendly, easier to do business in, and that's just music to our ears in the U.S. and to the delegation that I brought. I'm just really excited by what I'm seeing on the ground. And this is actually the very first ever presidential mission on behalf of the United States to the Philippines. So it's a historic mission in that respect. The message is the United States is committed to the Philippines, is going to continue to show up in the Philippines. These business leaders that I've brought want to continue to show up and do more and more here. We are engaging more and more economically in the Indo-Pacific region. But the Philippines is special. 72-year ironclad, rock-solid treaty partner, cultural ties, a lot of business ties, an important national security tie.
All right, we were listening to a report by Jackie Pascual on the trade mission of the United States to the Philippines and an interview with Gina Raimondo. We'll try to get more details of that story as they become available.
A new national treasurer takes the helm at the Philippine Treasury Bureau. Deputy Treasurer Sharon Almanza was formally appointed to the role after almost 6 months as officer in charge. She is among the new appointees in the finance portfolio. At the Finance Department, former NEDA Undersecretary Rolando Tumpalan was named Undersecretary of the agency's Corporate Affairs Group, while former ADB Advisor Jovan Balbosa will lead the International Finance Group. There's also a new Assistant Secretary for the Revenue Operations Group. These appointments are part of the government's move to consolidate its finances and steer the economy towards inclusive growth. After dominating the e-commerce sector in Southeast Asia, the Alibaba-backed shopping platform Lazada is now targeting an enhancement of its entertainment products. Lazada CEO Carlos Barrera told Market Edge the plan to boost its live streaming and gaming products is part of its bid to strengthen its online presence.
I think the digital space is always exciting and it's always very competitive. And we love to embrace that type of competition and to continue to do well, right? You have to remember that in the Philippines today, online penetration has grown a lot, but it's still relatively small. So what matters is to continue developing online, to continue creating more opportunities for everybody in the country. That's our mission and that's our goal, right? Mm-hmm. That said, I think it's very important to have strong entertainment features, right? The reality today is that everybody knows Lazada as the place to go and buy. They know that we're trustworthy, that you can get a good refund, you get good experience. But one of the key areas where we've been spending a lot over the past year is really on entertainment. Definitely, we see Filipinos are really strong when it comes to content. They love social media. They're very familiar with content, especially video form. So we have also launched a lot of our mechanics now. We have Last Like, where you can watch quick videos in the feed and you can actually rate and give feedback on some of the products. We have a lot of our live stream. We have built very strong live streamer content and many brands that are live streaming with us that actually offer good deals while they're live streaming. And we believe that video content is actually very, very popular and it's a good long-term option. We also want people to come and play some games. So if you look at Lazada today, we have our Lazada games. We have more than 6 games that people are coming to play. it's very interesting, but the majority of users are already playing with these games and earning some of these coins. Uh-huh. And we want to ramp up our entertainment options.